Very good. Thank you, Michael. At this time, I'd like to welcome everyone to the Town of Lexington Council meeting. This meeting is being held at Town Hall Monday evening, October 2nd, 2023. I'm Steve McDougall, the mayor of Lexington. This time, I'd like to introduce my fellow council members. To my left is Mayor Pro Tem Hazel Livingston. To her left is Councilmember Todd Carnes.
Good evening.
To his left is Councilmember Gavin Smith.
Good evening.
To my right is Councilmember Kathy Manis.
Good evening.
To her right is Councilmember Ron Williams.
Good evening.
To his right is Councilmember Todd Lyle.
Good evening.
At this time, I would like to ask on Councilmember Kathy Manis if she would give opening invocation for tonight's meeting.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Let us pray. Dear Lord, I just thank you for this beautiful day, for this fall weather that we're getting ready to have. And I just thank you for the change of season. And thank you for this council and for our staff at the Town of Lexington and all of our citizens and everything we do to make Lexington a great place to live. And be with us as we make the hard decisions. Be with us as we make those decisions that we know will make life in Lexington so much better. Be with those who are hurting tonight, Lord, and just thank you for all you do. We love you. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Ms. Manis. This time, I would like to welcome Lexington County veteran, Mr. Terry Hicks. Terry, good to see you again. I'd like for you to come forward and lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. For everyone, please stand and remove your hats.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mr. Hicks, thank you for being with us again. Yes. How are you? How you been?
I've been good. I'm going to be on first name basis then pretty soon, right?
Yes, you are.
Yeah. Our veteran groups are still going strong. Still got open invitations for anybody who'd like to come, as far as the veterans or what have you. Don't cost you nothing to join. And, of course, I was in the Army, and I was drafted. I didn't want to go, but I went, but I'm glad I did. Been quite some time ago. I was in Vietnam, but it ain't been so long for me. But we still struggle through it, and we got good help there with our group. And we got a wonderful counselor, and she takes care of us. Good. So, and it's good to see all of you again, and thank you.
It's always good to see you, Terry, and thank you for coming out and being a part of our community.
You're quite welcome, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you for your sacrifice.
Yes, sir.
At this time, I will call the meeting to order. I'd like to report on our executive session this evening. Tonight's executive session, we had two routine personnel matters. We had one routine administrative personnel matter. Under legal, we had five legal issues, one issue regarding utilities tower rental contract. One was an issue regarding utilities condemnation case. Third was litigation regarding Forever Chemicals. The fourth one was issue regarding an impact fee appeal. And the last one was advice regarding agenda items. We had one contractual issue. That was a downtown development related contract. No vote was taken in executive session other than to vote to adjourn executive session. Do I have a motion to ratify the mayor's executive session report?
So moved.
Mr. Lyle makes a motion. Is there a second?
I'll second it.
Ms. Manis seconds the motion. All those in favor, please raise your right hand. That is unanimous. Deletions on the agenda. Are there any deletions on tonight's agenda? Madam Clerk, I think we have a reversal of order. First is old number two and old number five. We're going to switch Councilmember Smith and Councilmember Carnes. And then I believe there is some old number five, we're going to remove it off of the agenda. Anyone else have anything they'd like to remove? Very good. We clear there? All right, very good. At this time, we'll move into approval of minutes. A copy of the minutes from the council meeting on July 10th, the special council meeting on September 18th, and the work session on September 18th, 2023, were provided to you in your packets. Are there any omissions, additions, or corrections? Again, council meeting July 10th, special council meeting September 18th, and work session September 18th.
Make a motion to approve and submitted.
Mr. Williams makes a motion. Is there a second?
I'll second it.
Ms. Maynes seconds the motion. All those in favor, please raise your right hand. Those minutes are approved unanimously. At this time, we'll move into presentations. Our first presentation this evening, we'd like to welcome Debbie Dickinson from the League of Women Voters. Y'all please come forward, join us at the microphone. Thank you for being with us.
Thank you so much for having us. I'm Debbie Dickinson. This is Rachel Dieter. We're with the League of Women Voters of the Columbia area, and we wanted to make a presentation this evening about Vote 411. And the League of Women Voters, as I'm sure many of you know, is a nonpartisan organization, and we work to promote voter participation in the upcoming elections. And the League is seeking to inform and engage citizens in the democratic process. We developed vote411.org, which is a website, an online voter's guide, where voters can go and get information about upcoming elections that would include things like voter registration, voting and polling place locations, absentee early and election day voting. And just as a reminder about voting, if you're not registered, you have until October 8th. And if you've moved or need to change anything, you have till October 8th to update that information. Our voter guide is the really neat thing about it is the voter just has to type in their address and they get a list of all the candidates who've actually filed for office in one place. And then the League follows up with a request to those candidates for information. And so we have the information about how to contact them, their social media contacts, their websites if they have them. And then we go beyond that in that we contact the candidates and we ask them where they stand on some of the critical issues. And they each have a chance to respond in their own words. And so when the voter goes to that website and looks up who are the candidates, they'll also see where does the candidate stand on the issues, and it gives them all that information in one place, and they don't have to go hunting around to all the different websites to find out, you know, just some basics about them. So we know the upcoming election will be November the 7th, and so far, well, they just got the invitation, but so far only one candidate has responded. So if there are any other candidates in the audience, which I know there's at least a couple.
They're all here.
Yeah, good. We would like to encourage you to participate. And that was just to prompt you in that. If a voter goes to the website and you haven't responded, it'll say the candidate has not responded. So it doesn't always look real good if you don't respond. So, and it gives you a chance to put in your own words what you think are the most important issues. We don't try and put trick questions in there, but just a chance for you to really say where you stand. And so it's a great opportunity, and if you are a candidate and you need more information, Rachel is our administrator, and so if you have any questions, the phone number on the invitation that you got will actually be sent to her. Anyhow, I don't know if she directly gets it. Yeah, she gets the phone calls, and she'll help you out if you have any questions about it. And then voters, they can get a lot of information about the elections that are coming up. But we still are not able to keep all the polling place information updated. So they still might have to go to SC Votes to do that. And just as a reminder to voters also that we now have early voting. And early voting will be available at the Lexington County Registration and Elections Office Monday through Friday, starting October the 23rd and running through November the 3rd. And so we would just encourage everybody to promote Vote 411 because it's a great source of nonpartisan information about the upcoming elections. We have given to the town clerk's office some posters that could be put up here on the town buildings. We also have some business cards just as a reminder to people when the election is And on the back, it tells a little bit about what information they can get on Vote 411. It is a website, so it's vote411.org. Or if you just Google Vote 411, it'll pop up. Or if you use any other search engine, too. Just as a reminder, it is nonpartisan. We don't support or oppose any specific candidates. And the Vote 411 website is gaining in popularity. During 2022 general election, there were 83,000 people, individuals in the state who used Vote 411 and over 6,200 in Lexington County. So we think it is a growing way to reach people, and it's free. So, you know, we hope that you'll participate. We hope that voters will use it. And I appreciate the opportunity to be here.
Very good, Debbie. Thank you all for being with us. Appreciate you being here. Would you like to say anything?
I have nothing more to add. I think she filled in everything.
Okay. I just didn't want you to make the trip for and not miss an opportunity. Very good. Thank you all for being with us. At this time, I will move into the vision plan update for October. The majority of the playground equipment in Virginia Hilton Park has been installed. Grading work for the trails on the South Church Street side of the project has begun, and we hope to have that park open by the spring of next year. Construction also continues on the trail around the Old Mill Pond. The 1 mile long paved trail will be lighted and feature police call boxes throughout the trail. It will also be dog friendly, with a total of 6 entry points to access it for your pleasure. For a list of the town's vision plan projects, please visit our website at lexsc.com. At this time, we'll move into a traffic update from Mayor Pro Tem Hazel Livingston.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. There will be intermittent lane closures along Thompson Street at West Main Street as road improvements are made in this area. Please use caution. The new traffic pattern along Glassmaster and Bruner Road is now complete. Construction will soon begin on Sunset Boulevard at the intersection of Whiteford Way as a new right turn lane is installed. The next traffic committee meeting is scheduled for October the 11th at 8 a.m. And if you have any reports for traffic signal issues, unsafe roadway conditions, or potholes that need to be repaired, please call 803-358-7273.
Very good. Thank you, Mayor Pro Tem. At this time, we'll move into public hearings. Speakers are limited to 5 minutes. Our first item this evening is final reading of an ordinance to amend the zoning ordinance creating special requirements related to car wash locations. Anyone here wish to speak to that? Hearing none. Item number 2, final reading of an ordinance creating the Small Business Advisory Committee. Anyone here wish to speak to that? Hearing none. Item number 3, final reading of an ordinance annexing Lexington County Tax Map 5497-04-001 and 5497-04029. Located at 108 Railroad Avenue. Anyone here wish to speak to that? Hearing none, our final item this evening, final reading of an ordinance amending section 72.47D, fine for handicapped parking violations. Anyone here wish to speak to that? That concludes our public hearings for this evening. We'll move right into old business. Our first item of old business is from Councilmember Kathy Manis. This is final reading of an ordinance to amend the zoning ordinance creating special requirements related to car wash locations. Councilmember Manis.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Over the last few years, the town has seen a significant increase in the number of proposed automated car washers. These businesses utilize loud buzzers to signal equipment startup, have large blowers to dry cars, and utilize outdoor vacuums that operate the entire time the business is open. These features present unique opportunities for noise complaints and other potential conflicts if the business is located too close to residential properties. During the August Planning Commission meeting, the Commission recommended amending the zoning ordinance to require a new car wash business to be located at least 500 feet from any residential property line. I make a motion for final reading approval.
Ms. Manis makes a motion, is there a second?
Second.
Mr. Williams seconds the motion, any further discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor, please raise your right hand. That is unanimous. Our next item of old business is from Councilmember Gavin Smith. This is final reading of an ordinance creating the Small Business Advisory Committee. Councilmember Smith.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Town Council has been asked to consider approving the creation of a Small Business Advisory Committee. The committee shall be charged with making recommendations to Town Council regarding ordinances, policies, and procedures either impacting the small business community or that would be beneficial to small business were they to be adopted. Periodic reports may be made to Town Council on progress or upon specific recommendations. The committee will sunset on December the 31st, 2025, and the committee in terms of appointees may only be extended by subsequent ordinance passed by the Town Council. An ordinance authorizing the creation of the committee is attached, and I make a motion, Mr. Mayor, for final reading approval.
Councilmember Smith makes a motion. Is there a second?
Second.
Mayor Pro Tem seconds that motion. Any further discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor, please raise your right hand. That is unanimous. Our next item of old business is from Councilmember Ron Williams. This is final reading of an ordinance annexing Lexington County Tax Map 5497-04-001 and 5497-04029, located at 108 Railroad Avenue. Councilmember Ron Williams.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. McCutcheon Holdings LLC owns approximately 12.58 acres on two parcels located at 108 Railroad Avenue and has petitioned to annex the property. An electrician's office is being planned on the site. Properties in town near this one are zoned general commercial and high density residential. Railroad Avenue is classified as a local road. The Planning Commission reviewed this annexation during their August meeting and recommended limited commercial zoning for the parcel. They also recommended classifying Railroad Avenue as a local road. I make a motion for final reading approval.
Mr. Williams makes a motion. Is there a second?
I'll second. Second.
Councilmember Smith seconds that motion. Any further discussion?
Mr. Mayor?
Yes.
I'm going to recuse myself. I had a little bit of involvement in this transaction.
Very good. Madam Clerk, we'll get you the final paperwork for that.
Thank you.
Mr. Lyle will recuse himself for this vote. Anyone else have any comments or questions? There's a motion and a second. All those in favor, please raise your right hand. That is unanimous. Our next item of old business is Councilmember Todd Lyle. This is final reading of an ordinance amending Section 72.47D, fine for handicap parking violation. Councilmember Lyle.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. State law under Title 56, Chapter 3, Article 17, Subsection 1910, more specifically Sub J, Subparagraph 2, requires that anyone found guilty of illegally parking in a handicap parking zone must be imprisoned for not more than 30 days or fined not less than $500 nor more than $1,000, which represents the maximum under our code. The state legislature's use of the word, quote, must, end quote, indicates the requirement suggested is mandatory. Therefore, the town should consider amending its code of ordinance to align with this requirement and again follow state law. The town code of ordinances has conflicting provisions in this topic, neither of which is consistent with state law, of which is the town's ordinance section 72.47 initially set that fine at $100. Later, section 75.12 was added and increased the penalty to $150, still short of the $500 minimum. It is suggested that the town repeal that previously mentioned code section and amend section 72.47 subparagraph D to increase the fine to comply with state law. These changes are contained in the attached ordinance. Mr. Mayor, I'd make a motion for first reading approval for our local ordinance to fall in line with state law.
Very good. Councilmember Lyle makes a motion. Is there a second?
Second.
Councilmember Corn seconds that motion. Any further discussion? I'll just ask, Mr. Coon, this is just a little bit of cleanup on our side as far as the ordinance goes.
That's correct. The old one would be repealed by implication, but it's better to just get it off the books altogether.
Right. Very good. Anyone else have any questions or comments? Motion and a second. All those in favor, please raise your right hand. That is unanimous. Our next item of old business is from, I'm sorry, that's the number five. That's the one we took off. I'm not going to read that one. Thank you. We'll move right into new business. Our first item of new business is from Mayor Pro Tem Hazel Livingston. This is first reading of an ordinance to adopt the updated standard business license rate class schedule by NAICS Code. Mayor Pro Tem.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. The Statewide Business Standardization Act requires municipalities to adopt the updated standard rate classes in every odd year for implementation in the next even year business license cycle. I make a motion for first reading of an ordinance to adopt the updated standard business license rate class schedule by NAICS code.
Very good. Mayor Pro Tem makes a motion. Is there a second?
I'll second it.
Gavin. Councilmember Smith, thank you. Second set motion. Any further discussion?
Mr. Mayor, I would like to confirm that staff hasn't we've made sure that the chamber knows these changes so they can share it with their membership.
Was at the board meeting last week, I believe it was, and shared it at that point with them, let them know that most folks are going to see a decline. About 82% of the folks that change class are going to see a slight decline, and no business will see an increase of over $100 and 10% of their previous business license. And our revenue is actually going to go down by a modest amount, $11,000, as a result.
Awesome. Thank you.
Very good. Anyone else? We have a motion and a second. All those in favor, please raise your right hand. That is unanimous. Our next item of new business is from Councilmember Kathy Manis. This is Paving Dirt Roads. Councilmember Manis, sounds like a country song.
You don't want me to sing it either. Thank you, Mr. Mayor. During the September 18th work session, Council requested an updated cost from Lexington County on paving four existing dirt roads in the town limits. The total cost provided in the attached Lexington County Public Works cost estimate is $434,539.40. The roads would remain under county maintenance. The four roads include Bellwood Drive, Barrett Drive, Michael Street, and Laurel Street. I make a motion for council approval.
Ms. Manis makes a motion. Is there a second?
Second. I'll second it.
Oh, my gosh.
It's a race.
All of us second it.
All right. Is there anyone on the desk that doesn't second
it? Just pick somebody, Becky.
All right. Very good. Mayor Pro Tem seconds. Any further discussion?
Mr. Mayor?
Yes, sir. Mr. Lyle?
Just for clarification, Mr. Ford, was it brought up that this is the last remaining dirt roads and the county was frustrated with bringing their motor graders into town? Could you give us a little backstory on this?
Yes, sir. There are a few more dirt roads in the town. These are with a residential population on them. And
correct.
There was concern about the county wanting to not have to bring in their heavy equipment periodically. And so we have reached out and are working with the county on this measure to try to get it done as expedited as possible and in the most cost-effective manner.
So they're sharing in this cost with us, this effort?
They're willing to participate in and doing the work.
Okay.
And we'll pay an appropriate fee.
Thank you.
Very good. Anyone else?
Stuart, how many other dirt roads are in the town?
I'll let Mr. Edwards answer that. He's probably got it on the tip of his tongue.
Good evening.
Hey, Mayor Randy, Kelly. Thank you for being with us.
Sure. Total miles in town is just under 3 miles. This actually is 0.83 miles total for these four roads. But as I think Stuart started to allude to, almost all the other roads have some encumbrance, whether it be railroad right-of-way. They're part of One of them is tucked into the Corley Mill Gateway project. And then we've identified one as it's 500 foot. It kind of acts like a driveway, but yet it is a public dirt road. So when you add it all up, we get to a total in town of 3.1, or just under that. That number was incorrect. It's like 2.9 miles. In town right now, we're taking almost 0.9 miles off. So there'll still be 2 miles remaining, but they are encumbered by various challenges.
Very good. Thank you, Randy. Anyone else? I'd like to thank Councilmember Darrell Hudson for turning this around pretty quick. We got him a message last week, and he got us an answer pretty quick. And then all of County Council for being involved and actually saying that they would do this project for us. So it was a team effort. Very good. We have a motion and a second. All those in favor, please raise your right hand. That is unanimous.
And I'd like to thank Kathy and Don for bringing it up to me at church.
Very good. Glad you went to church that day.
That's right.
Our next item of new business is from Councilmember Todd Carnes. This is Mission Lexington sponsor request. Councilmember Carnes.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Mission Lexington will hold an oyster roast fundraising event in the town's Ice House Pavilion on November 17th, 2023, and have requested the town's support. At the September 18th work session, a $500 donation towards this event was proposed. Robin Bowers requested the Parks Department to assist with 4 oyster tables, 15 long tables, and chairs to be used for this event. A list of sponsor levels and a statement of purpose for Mission Lexington are attached. Mr. Mayor, in light of Mission Lexington's ongoing support of our police department and how they assist them regularly, I make a recommendation for a $500 donation to this event.
Mr. Carnes makes a motion. Is there a second?
Second.
Councilmember Lyle seconds that motion. Any further discussion?
Mr. Mayor.
Yes, sir. Mr. Williams.
Due to the fact that I am the operations director for Mission Lexington, I will recuse myself.
Very good. We'll get the proper paperwork for Mr. Williams as well. Anyone else?
Mr. Mayor, I'd just like to clarify.
Yes, sir.
As we discussed at the last meeting, I feel like the language in here needs to be cleaned up a little bit because a $500 donation was requested. So that's as if we're just handing $500 rather than doing a $500 sponsorship. Can we clean that language up?
Absolutely.
So you want to do the aw shucks sponsorship?
I think that's what we agreed to at the last work session.
Very good. We'll need to amend that motion. Mr. Carnes, if you'd like to amend that motion.
Do you want to amend it?
Mr. Mayor, I move to amend new business item number 3 to change the word donation to sponsorship.
Very good. Councilmember Smith amends that motion. Is there a second?
Second.
Councilmember Lyle seconds it. Any further discussion? You good? Very good. All those in favor, please raise your right hand. That is unanimous. Our next item of new business is from Councilmember Todd Lyle. This is the Sertoma Club sponsorship request. Councilmember Lyle.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. The Lexington Sertoma Club will hold their annual Big Thursday event in the town's Ice House Pavilion on October the 19th, later this month, and they have requested support. They have not given a specific request, but the breakdown from recent donations is as follows. In 2018, they requested 500, or were given 500. 2020, they were given 500. 2022, they were given 600. The levels of sponsorship information in the Big Thursday event poster are attached. In light of our history here, Mr. Mayor, I'd make a motion for council consideration in the amount of $500.
Councilmember Lyle makes a motion. Is there a second?
I'll second it.
Councilmember Williams seconds that motion. Any further discussion?
I have one.
Yes, Ms. Maness.
So in 2022, we gave $600. And if you look at the sponsorship, the difference between 500 and 600 is that you get the table of 8 for 600, which many of us over the past have attended this. So I don't know if we want to make it 600 so that we will have tickets to go, or that's
I'm going to be out of town. I can't go. So that's entirely up to y'all.
I'm okay with five.
All right.
Okay.
Thank you for the suggestion. We have a motion and a second. All those in favor, please raise your right hand. That is unanimous. Our next item of new business is from Councilmember Gavin Smith. This is the Vision Plan Advisory Committee. Councilmember Smith.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. At the August 21st and the September 18th work sessions, Council discussed the formation of a Vision Plan Advisory Committee. This committee would be charged with reviewing, reassessing, and updating the town's vision plan to ensure that it aligns with the wants and needs of our community and report to the Council. Members of the existing advisory committee have been invited to submit boards and commissions applications for the Vision Plan Advisory Committee. The 7 submitted applications are attached. Mr. Mayor, I make a motion for council approval.
Councilmember Smith makes a motion. Is there a second?
Second.
Mayor Pro Tem seconds the motion. Any further discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor, please raise your right hand. That is unanimous. And thank all 7 members, additional members that re-upped. We were thinking nobody wanted to be on that, but we're certainly glad they did. At this time, we'll move into announcements from Councilmember Ron Williams.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. We hope everyone enjoyed this year's Market at Ice House. The last one was Saturday, but it will return next year. I'd like to take this time to thank Walker Brewer for another very successful year of the market. We still have a lot more going on at the Ice House. Walker does an excellent job for us. The Board of Zoning will meet this Thursday at 5:30 here in the Council Chambers. The Board of Appearance will meet on October the 10th at 5:30 here in Council Chambers. Town Council will meet again on October the 16th at 6 p.m. in the Conference Center for the Council Work Session. The Planning Commission will meet on October the 18th at 8 a.m. here in Council Chambers. Fall is always a busy season at the Town Ice House Amphitheater. This Thursday is the last free Ice House Live concert for this year. We welcome Too Much Sevilla back to the stage. Come out at 6:30 and enjoy some great music. October the 6th at 6 is the night of the 90s grunge rock with Fallapalooza. Tickets are $18 and can be purchased on the Town's Ice House Amphitheater.com website. October 13th at 6 is an evening with the Stealing Peaches, performing the music of the Allman Brothers Band. Tickets are $25 and can be purchased on the Town's Ice House Amphitheater.com website. October 20th and 21st at 6 p.m., Resurrection is back for 2 nights. This Journey tribute band is great, and they welcome their new singer, Brian Cole. Tickets are $25, and I understand that Friday night is sold out, and a few tickets are still available for Saturday. Last but certainly not least, the Lexington Police Department will host their annual famous LPD Foundation Fall Festival on Tuesday, October 24th from 5:30 to 8:30. The men and women of the Lexington Police Department and their volunteers really set the bar high on this event for our children. They will have rides, games, food, music, and a costume contest with prizes for the children and the adults. Attendance is limited to 2,000 folks, and tickets are $5 each, and children 5 and under are free. All proceeds go to the Lexington Police Department Foundation to further the work of the officers and their community-focused programs. We certainly hope to see you there. Thank you for tuning in to tonight's Lexington Town Council meeting.
Thank you, Mr. Williams. Any other member of council have anything they'd like to add?
Mr. Mayor.
Yes, sir. Mr. Smith.
If I would, or if I may, I'd just like to announce that I will be doing my 4th Open Door After 4 meeting. I announced back in July that I was doing every once a month on Thursdays at 4 p.m. in the conference center, where constituents can come from 4 to 6 p.m. I meet with them on any topic. If you have a question, a concern, or you just want to get to know me, I'd love to get to know you. You can come on October the 12th, which is not this Thursday, but next. I'll be in the conference center from 4 o'clock until 6 o'clock, and I'd love to meet you and work with you on an issue or just get to know you.
Very good. Thank you, Councilmember Smith. Anyone else?
Mr. Mayor?
Yes, Ms. Manis.
So I'm glad that the 411 people were here tonight to talk about the importance of voting. We have a very important election in the town of Lexington on Tuesday, November the 7th. So it's very important that the citizens in the town of Lexington go vote. If you are not registered, you may get registered to vote. If you do it in person, it needs to be by Friday, October 6th at 5 o'clock at our county voter registration office. You can register online at scvotes.gov. Those forms need to be received by October the 8th if you fax it or email it. And if you mail it in, it has to be postmarked by Tuesday, October 10th. So those dates are coming up very quickly. So if you're watching this and you are not registered to vote, please get registered to vote. Also, early voting will begin on October 23rd through November the 3rd, and that's from 8:30 to 5 at our Lexington County office located at 605 West Main Street in Lexington. Also, it's very important that our citizens pay attention to the candidates who are running to serve on council. All seven of them are here tonight. Do not go in and just check a box. Pay attention. We have some candidates who are running who will continue to make Lexington a great place to live, work, worship, and go to school. But in my opinion, we have some running who will set the town of Lexington back. So it's very important that you study the candidates. We want Lexington to continue to be the best place to live. And the best way to do that is to elect good people to serve as a member of Lexington Town Council. I encourage you to do that, get registered to vote, and be sure to vote on November the 7th. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Ms. Manis. Anyone else have anything they'd like to add? Very good. That concludes our announcements. Are there any questions from the news media? Thank you for being with us. Any public comments tonight regarding tonight's agenda? Yes, ma'am. Please come forward. If you don't mind, please state your name and address for the record. Good evening.
Good evening. My name is Paula Kaufman. I live at 201 Allenbrook Way in Wellesley. While I have the microphone, I am going to thank our mayor and our council member, Kathy Menace, for their service.
Thank you very much.
Now, with respect to Mayor Pro Tem Livingston's item concerning traffic update, I attended a public meeting last Monday and was shocked and embarrassed to learn that the town of Lexington was not financially supporting efforts by Comet, which might alleviate some, but of course not all, of the traffic concerns that have been expressed repeatedly by our citizens, by our town candidates, and at an earlier vision plan discussion, me. Please reevaluate this position. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Ms. Kaufman. Is there anyone else have any public comments regarding agenda items for tonight? Very good. That concludes our business for this evening. Thank you for watching the town council meeting for the town of Lexington. This meeting was held at Town Hall on Monday evening, October 2nd, 2023. Recording of this meeting will be available for viewing on the town's YouTube channel. Without objection, we are adjourned.